There is a rather strange rule that applies to narrowing crosstalk if you're testing to any of the ISO limits or European norm limits called the 4dB rule. When we tap on the screen here for next, or I'll go to the worst performing pair, we see that part of the limit line is black and part of it is red. Where the limit line is black, any crosstalk measurement made in that region is ignored under the 4dB rule. What is the 4dB rule? If the insertion loss of the pair is less than 4dB, then that near-end crosstalk measurement is ignored. Let's see if we can find roughly where it turns from black to red on our limit line here and see what frequency that happens at. It's pretty close, getting there. Move it across one more. I think it's more like over here somewhere. About, I would say there. There, 188.5 megahertz. Remember that number. Now you'll notice a little bit after that it goes red and then black and then red again. And that's because of something called insertion loss deviation. It's not exactly smooth, the insertion loss, particularly when you're doing high frequency testing. So this is for crosstalk on 1.2.3.6. And I said the 4dB rule applies based on the insertion loss. Well, does it apply on the insertion loss of pair 1.2 or pair 3.6? It's pair 3.6. That's how it's defined in the standards. Let's go and look at the insertion loss on pair 3.6. So I'm at pair 3.6, and I'm going to move this to my 188.5 megahertz. I'm going to zoom in again. We'll zoom in quite excessively. Okay, so our insertion loss here is showing 3.9 dB, but the moment I move it forward, it changes to 4 dB. So what we can say here is 188.5 megahertz and backwards, we're actually going to ignore all those crosstalk measurements. Now, there's an interesting quirk with this 4 dB rule. Let me go and look at another test result. So when we look at the result here, we see the crosstalk has a margin of 3.3 dB. But you'll notice there's an I next to it, not a tick mark. And that's because if the insertion loss never reaches 4 dB, then you end up ignoring the entire near-end crosstalk measurement. When we look at this near-end crosstalk, we see that the entire limit line is black, so the entire measurement is ignored. If we go and look at the insertion loss, we can see here that it reported the worst case as 2.4 dB, not even close to 4 dB. So it's ignoring all of the crosstalk measurements. Now there is another interesting quirk. Let's look at this result here. The margin is minus 3.9 dB for near-end crosstalk. So that should be a fill, correct? Because minus is below the test limit. But the DSX is showing an I next to it, not an X. Why? Because the insertion loss on this particular link, quite short at 3.3 meters, never actually reached 4 dB. Let's look at that. Indeed, my worst case is 2.2 dB. It didn't reach 4 dB. So as a result, my entire limit line is black, and I ignore the entire near-end crosstalk measurement across the entire frequency range. So even though it dips below the limit line here, this is actually considered a pass under the 4 dB rule, which again is not found in TIA, but it is found in ISO and EN standards.